We're saying that there has not been any due diligence that's being done to the people getting their nationalization. We're not against people becoming Belizean citizens. What we are against is the process, the way they're going about it, the way they're like, it seems almost as if they're forcing people through the system. And I don't think that the department is doing its due diligence in terms of screening these people to make sure that they've lived here long enough, they've paid their taxes, they have abided by the law. And we think that there needs to be more due diligence. I mean, you have an entire year to do this, so why the rush just before the election? Right now, in Toledo East, this was done a few years ago, and today we have 50% of the people on the voters list in Toledo East are foreign nationals who were born outside of this country. And actually, they decide the fate of, you know, who's going to represent us. And I think as a Belizean, I'm very concerned about this, because if there's not no due diligence, then, you know, we don't know who we are giving citizenship to.
Would you say that you have seen this happen before, or would this be the first time you see it happen of this type?
No, this has happened under the PUP administration as well, but this is the first time of this type, of this magnitude. This is totally out of control. I would like to call on the government right now to ensure, or to the Elections and Boundaries Commission, to refrain from giving voters registration cards to these people until when we could really check this through. You know, I would like to ask that nobody registered within the past 2 months or within the past 3 months allowed to vote in this upcoming general election or in this upcoming municipal election. I am calling on all Belizeans and all civil society groups, COLA and the other watchdog groups, to express their displeasure with the way this is done. I mean, a few years ago when the PUP was in power, there was this group called Association of Concerned Belizeans. Where are they now? They are the ones that would have been speaking up about this. We'd like to call on them to speak out about this.